You are welcome to this PS Touch Beginner's Guide tutorial. In this video, we are going to learn some of the basics of PS Touch for absolute beginners. And here's the timestamp we'll be following in this video, so feel free to skip ahead. And here's the interface of our newly opened PS Touch app. If you take a look at the bottom of the screen, you will see two icons. One is mainly for import and the other is mainly for export. Let's click on the one for import because we are about to import an image. And now we click photo library. So these are the folders of all the images on this device. So let me locate the one which I have the project image on. I'll click on the image and then click add. So this is the working area in our PS Touch app. The first thing I want to grab your attention to is this icon at the bottom right. It shows you your layer dropdown, which contains all the images you imported to this project in form of layers. As you can see, we have only one layer. This dot icon represents the visibility of the layer. Once you click on it, it hides the layer, and clicking on it again reviews it. So let's collapse the layer dropdown and keep on moving. Looking at this portrait, I think it's gonna look cool if we change the color of our hair. Since we only want to apply an effect to the hair, we have to separate the hair from the main layer to its own layer using what we called selection. There are a lot of tools in making selection, but the one we're going to be focusing on today is the quick selection tool. To review your toolbar, click on this icon, drag up to the magic wand tool and all the way to the right to select the quick selection tool. That being done, I want you to take a look at this icon at the bottom of the screen. One of these icons is the brush and the other is the mode. Let's first talk about the brush. And here you see a lot of sliders. But trust me, the only one you're going to need is the size slider. Let's see what effect the size slider has. Now click and drag to make a selection. As you can see, a lot of areas were selected with just one click. Click on this icon here to undo your previous actions. Now let's see what will happen when we make the brush size smaller. As you can see, only few areas are being selected. Now we can go further and talk about the mode. There are three modes in this tool and we can switch them by clicking on it. The first mode is the normal mode, which is a form of a dotted rectangle. When the normal mode is active and you click and drag, it creates a new selection and after that, it changes its mode. Let's go back and do it again. And for this mode, which looks the same but a positive sign attached to it, it simply means adding to the selection. So when you click and drag, the selection continues. And the third mode, which have a negative sign attached to it, it simply means subtracting from the selection. Now let's go back to the normal mode. Click and drag within the selection to move it. Let's go back to the normal mode again. If you click and drag outside the selection, a new selection will be made, erasing that first one. I believe you now have a clear understanding on how to use this tool. So sit and relax and let me select this all through. Now we are done in making the selection, but we are not fully done yet. What I mean are the edges of this selection. They look pretty rough, so we are going to fix them. To do so, click at this icon at the top. Now click on the Refine Edge tool. Reduce the brush size and brush around the edges. As you can see, the edges looks better now. Click on OK and we are good to go. Now we have made a selection, the next thing is to separate it from its layer to its own layer. To do so, first of all, click on the layer dropdown to review your layers. Now click on this cross icon at the bottom right. Then click on layer from selection. As you can see, we now have the air in its own layer. Now we can apply any effect to just the air without affecting anything else. Before we move further, let's get rid of this selection. We don't need it anymore. Now we are about to change the color of the air, but before we do so, let's get rid of the initial color by turning it black and white. To do so, click on this adjustment icon above. Then click on black and white. Now we can apply any color to this with ease. Click on the adjustment icon again, but this time click on curves. Here we have red, green and blue. If you want the air to be blue, you can simply do so by dragging the curve right up. If you don't like it, you can cancel it by clicking on this icon and try other colors to see which one you like best. You can get more colors by dragging the curves right down. You can add even more colors by mixing the curves. I like the red color, so I'll leave mine red. Once you have satisfied, click OK to apply the effect. Now that you have done a great job, let's conclude by saving this project. Click on Done at the top left corner. Then save your project. Now your project has been saved. You can now export this project as an image file. And that's it for this episode. Subscribe to stay in touch for the next episode.